Hello friends, welcome back to my channel PU Zone. Myself Priya. Today I'm going to discuss about 18 stages of civil suit. I'm going to make 4 videos on this topic. Let me discuss those 18 stages point to point. The first point is presentation of plaint. The second one is service of summons on defendant. The third one is appearance of parties. The fourth one is ex parte decree. The fifth one is interlocutory proceedings. The sixth one is written statement, and the seventh, production of documents. Eighth one is examination of parties. The ninth one is discovery and inspection. Tenth one is admission. The 11th one is framing of issues. The 12th one is summoning and attendance of witness. 13th one is hearing of suit and examination of witness. 14th is argument, and the 15th one is judgment. The 16th one is preparation of decree. 17th, appeal, review and revision. The 18th one is execution of decree. Let us discuss in detail one by one. Now let us discuss the first one, that is presentation of plaint. The plaint shall contain the particulars which I am going to discuss now. The first one is name of the court. The second one is name, description and place of residence of plaintiff. The third one is name, description and place of residence of defendant. The fourth one is where the plaintiff is minor or unsound mind, statement to that effect. The fifth one is facts constituting the cause of action and when it arose. The sixth one is facts showing the jurisdiction of court. The seventh one is relief which the plaintiff claims. And the eighth one is statement of the value of the subject matter for the sake of jurisdiction of court and court fees. If after submitting the plaint, the court finds that it should be submitted before some other court, the plaint can be returned and intimation is given to the plaintiff. The court has power to reject the plaint on the grounds which I am going to discuss now. The first one is plaint does not disclose the cause of action. The second one is where the relief claimed is undervalued and plaintiff fails to correct the valuation within time fixed. The third one is if the relief is properly valued but the plaint fails to pay the court stamp fees. The fourth one is where the suit appears to be time barred. However, rejection of the plaint does not bar the plaintiff in presenting a fresh suit. Now let us discuss second point, that is service of summons. In simple words, summons is a legal document to appear before the court. When the suit is instituted, summons may be issued to defendant to appear and answer the claim. Defendant may appear in person or through pleader. If the summons is not served by normal process, then the court may order to affix the summons in the conspicuous part of the house. Conspicuous part means where it can be easily seen, or the court may order to advertise the summons in newspaper. I have discussed service of summons in detail in another video and I have mentioned link in the description box. Please go through. And next we are going to deal with the third point, that is appearance of parties. On the day fixed in the summons, the defendant is required to appear and answer, and if the defendant is absent, court may proceed ex parte. If it is found that the summons is not served upon defendant is consequence of failure of plaintiff to pay court fees or postal charges, then court may dismiss the suit. Where neither plaintiff nor the defendant appears, the court may dismiss the suit.